Hey guys, what's up? So after releasing my Starfield benchmark for the like comparing the game from 10 to 50 watts, I received some comments asking how am I managing to have fixed 50 watts gameplay. So in today's video, I'll show you how to lift off the shackles on your ally and have consistent 50 watts power. But please keep in mind, if your ally is already overheating at 30 watts, it's best not to push it any further. And by the way, if you are struggling already with temperatures, check out my other videos trying various cooling techniques. We are going to need a keyboard to navigate through some tool as the ally buttons and D-pad won't work there. Also, you will need a USB drive to boot up to that same tool. So naturally, you will need a sort of multi-adapter or docking station to connect all stuff at once. With that being said, let's jump right in. So first of all, we'll install a tool called Smokeless, which basically unlocks some AMD, PBS, and CBS options. The process is pretty straightforward, so you can rest assured if you follow my steps, any risk is unlikely to happen. And also, I've been running my ally this way for some time now. So now let's get over and download Smokeless. You can choose between the beta or the official versions. I've tried both of them and they function similarly for our purpose. So once downloaded, extract the file and prepare your USB drive by making sure it's formatted to FAT32. Finally, copy all files to it. Next, restart your ally and hold the volume down button as it's booting in order to enter the BIOS settings. Then press Y button to switch to advanced mode and then go to boot tab, set the first boot option to your USB drive. In my case, it's SanDisk USB drive. And also disable the second boot option. Under the security tab, go to secure boot and disable secure boot control. Now save those settings and exit to boot up Smokeless. And here we are. Unfortunately, I can't mirror this to the big screen and also I can't control the font size. So I apologize guys, I'll do my best to zoom in a way to make it visible. Let's now navigate to device manager and then go to AMD CBS. And lastly, go to CPU common options. Here I have the global C state disabled because this way you eliminate the performance variability that can occur when cores ramp up from low to high power state. It may remove some micro stutters in some games. Now return to the previous menu and head over to SMU common options. And here is our main target. Click on system configuration and set it to 54 watts. Now also under SPL control, switch it from auto to manual and dial 50,000 to achieve 50 watts. Of course, feel free to dial whatever watts you want. For example, if you want 40 watts, dial 40,000, etc. But you will need to adjust it also for PPT control settings for fast, slow, and slow time constant. Now finally, go back to the previous menu. It will prompt you whether you want to save your changes. Press the Y button on your keyboard and go back where we landed in the first menu and press continue. It will say configs have been set, so this way you will know it has worked well. Now as the system is booting, re-enter the BIOS menu and revert to your original boot, which is Windows, and secure boot back to enabled. I want to note that if you reset BIOS settings to default, it will remove all the settings we modded. Also, you can access that tool again and change all settings back to auto at any time given. Now I'll save the changes and reboot back to Windows. See you there. Now we are half done because in order to lock power limits on Windows, we'll need to install Handheld Companion, which is an app specifically for handhelds and of course, including the ROG ALLY. So install it and within the app, go to settings and enable configurable power TDP override. Here you can set your minimum and maximum power limits. In my case, it's 50 watts for max and 5 for minimum. Also, if you go up here, you can set it to start with Windows, run in background, and stuff like that. So I'll enable all of them. Additionally, you can set a hotkey for the quick menu for in-game modifications. For example, here I am assigning the back macro button for it. And in this quick menu, you can also enable and disable CPU boost as well as change power TDP right in-game. What's also cool is that with this setup, there is no need to uninstall Armory Crate. You can still control your fan curve and other stuff through it. And there you have it. Now I'll show you some Starfield comparison between the default max turbo 30 watts and our new defined turbo, the 50 watts. So as we have seen in the comparison, from 30 watts to 50 watts, the performance increase is very minimal. For example, in Starfield, maybe 3 FPS at best. I wouldn't call it worth having it on 50 watts, especially for the unnecessary heat that it will generate. But it's good to know that we are able to lift off the predefined power limits should it was needed. Also, knowing this will be useful for future Ryzen APUs. Who knows, maybe they would get more gains by increasing the power limit. So that's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you found it useful. If you run into any issue, please let me know in the comments or over in Discord. And subscribe to stay updated on all latest Ally content. See you in the next one.